great to see you, and you must be on a high bearing in mind last weekend, or have you put that to bed now?
It was nice. I think we've got to enjoy the win when it comes, because obviously we've been playing and not getting the points, and it was nice to win 3-0, get 3 points and put in a good performance.
And certainly you as an individual put in a great performance. Satisfaction you must take from that as well.
Yeah, not just me, the whole team. We've been putting in performances and not really getting the results. To go to Emirates in the midweek game and take a point, and obviously finish it off with the three here, it was a good week. 4 points is a good week.
There has been some conversation about, you know, when you guys then came back into training in the beginning part of the week, that maybe you were feeling a bit more relaxed about things, perhaps a little bit too relaxed. Is that fair? I mean, have you seen a sort of a step up in sort of intensity from you guys throughout the course of the week?
Don't really know how to answer that. I think we train with intensity most every day, to be honest with you now. We do train with intensity. I think it steps up considerably from the start towards the end of the week. But like I said, we're just looking forward to each game as it comes now and putting as many points on the board as we can to the end of the season.
Boss has said that, you know, you are Mr. Consistency as far as he's concerned, and it's a brilliant thing for him to be able to rely on. That's a nice accolade to get from the manager.
Yeah, it's. I saw it the other day. It's a nice statement from Monks. I mean, we all know what position we was in, well, a week ago or so ago. So 4 points makes a hell of a lot of a difference to it. But it was one of them where everyone had to knuckle up, pull their socks up, and put in shifts and work hard. And if you work hard, the results will follow. And that's what happened last week.
Do you feel you're working as much as you want to be? Is there more to be had from Wayne Routledge?
I'd like to think so, but where I'm at now and where the team's at, is we're in a good place, and hopefully we can take that into the game on Saturday.
Obviously, coming off the back of the results against Norwich, which was absolutely brilliant, and the 3 points so vital and everything, is there ever a danger, though, when you get a result like that, that you can sort of breathe a bit of a sigh of relief and slightly take your foot off the gas?
No, because the manager, Monks has been on us all week as usual, so... The training's been intense and the quality's been high, and I'm sure we're going to the game on Saturday the same as we have been the last few weeks.
And what's your mentality now about it? Are you sort of idealistically thinking, right, we're going to win every game between now and the end of the season, or are you a bit more practical about it than that and thinking, right, as long as we make sure we get this one and that one, I think that's what...
We came in on the weekend, well, not on the weekend, in the midweek, we was training, and he put a bold statement to us and said, don't lose another game to the end of the season, and that's where we're at. I think it's a good mentality to have, and I think it showed that I think Ashley's block on the line the weekend personified that whole point, because it was a crucial part of the game for us, and if that went in, who knows, but he put his body on the line and the rest of us have been doing that, and we got the result, so we just got to take it from there.
Absolutely. And there's no secret that it's been a pretty intense schedule for you guys over the course of the season, with European commitments as well as Premier League. I mean, it's been a pretty packed fixture schedule. How are you feeling now as a collective? Are you starting to feel it? Is there some tiredness creeping in at all, or is there a new lease of life now? What's the sort of sense amongst you?
I don't think there was no time to feel tired before. The games came thick and fast, and we just had to get through them the best way we could, and we gave it our all. And In the end against Napoli, it weren't enough. But now, obviously, all that's out of the way, and it's basically down to the league. So there's enough rest time and enough recuperation to get ready and get right for the next game after you take the game.
And obviously, it's still a situation where you can't actually say, right, we are safe now at this point in time. There is still some work to do. I wonder, sort of, as an individual, as a player, what lessons you've learned from being in this situation? Because it's not a situation Swansea have found themselves in the first two seasons in the top flight.
No, it's not. It's not a nice situation to be in. But like I said, when you're in the situation, you need people in there that are gonna give their all for the cause and work as hard as they can. And like I said, we've been putting in the performances and working hard, and we haven't really been getting the results until the last week. So it was nice to get the 4 points within a week.
But have you discovered any sort of inner mental strength in yourself that perhaps you didn't realise you had?
No. I've been in the game a long time now, and it takes a lot of mental strength to still be here, so I ain't learned that much new.
Well, very glad you are still here. Best of luck for the weekend.
Thank you.
Wayne, can you go unbeaten for the rest of the season?
It'd be a tough one, but why not? It's a tough ask, but why not? Why shouldn't we believe what we can't?
Do you feel that you're almost there as far as staying up is concerned, or maybe you've done enough already?
No, I can't really see that being enough. I mean, like I said, we play each game as it comes, and we hopefully get more and more results, and the performances are there. It's just the results. So if we can keep putting in the same performances, we'll get the results, and it hopefully will be enough to drag us away from there.
But clearly, you know, the draw at Arsenal, the win over Norwich, that's eased some of the pressure, hasn't it? You're not in the thick of the dogfight now.
No, not in the thick of it, but we're not away from it. Like I said, the last week has given us a good platform to build on. And like I said before, we go into the game at home with a bit more confidence than we did before, and hopefully put on the same kind of performance and hopefully come away with 3 points.
Gary has made the point that you've played almost every minute under him, which is a real shot in the arm to you, isn't it? It's a real sort of vote of confidence in your ability.
Yeah, I mean, to know really that you're involved and the manager thinks highly of you is a nice feeling to go into games with. Sometimes you go into games on edge thinking you've got to do this and you've got to do that, but when you know someone believes in you, it's a lot easier to go on the pitch and do what you have to do.
And it shows you've responded as well, because if your performance dropped, you know what would happen.
You've hit the nail on the head. He's on everyone in training and in the games, and if your performance ain't there, you're going to know about it. He's not going to let you off lightly, so everyone has to be on their game.
Are you playing as well as you have done in the Premier League for some time, or as best as you
can? Not only me, I think the team's in a good place at the moment. We're all playing to a decent standard. And I said, we have been putting in performances, just not getting the results. To go away to Anfield and score 3, to go Goodison and score 2, not many teams are going to do that. It's just small lapses in concentration and stuff. But obviously, if we get rid of them, we're going to be a match for anyone.
Gary has also said it's not outrageous to think about you being on a plane to Brazil this summer, not for a holiday.
Who knows? I don't even look that far forward. I take most things day at a time and then game after game and see where it takes me.
But, I mean, if the club keeps playing well, there's always one, I won't say surprise, but late sort of arrival in a squad like that, isn't
there? Yeah, there's always a late arrival. Who knows where it's going to come from? But that's not the top of my agenda at the moment.
And likewise, he said, well, sometimes he feels that Swansea is so far away from the beaten track, maybe not just you, but other players down here are almost overlooked. Do you feel that at all?
I'll be stepping on a few landmines at the moment, but for me, Leon Britton's one of the best midfielders in the Premier League. His stats, what he does for the back four, his passing ability, how he reads the game. I think the only thing that goes against him really is his age, but he can still do it in the Premier League and he's still doing it now, so he'd definitely be in my thoughts.
Is that right? He'd still...
Leon is very, very underrated, in my opinion.
But do the players feel that it's almost out of sight, out of mind down here, despite the...
We don't even talk about it. It's out of our hands. It's something that we're not in control of. The only thing we're in control of is what we do on a Saturday. So that's all we can concentrate on.
Should have been Welsh. Cheers.
All right.